going to read Scientific American's publications of discoveries from the deep. Advances in robotics, sensing, and genomics are accelerating discovery in the darkest ocean depths. Scientists that are finding a sophisticated life field place than they ever expected. Put a human in the sea, and they're pretty useless, says marine ecologist Kelly J. Benoit, part of the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute.
Venture to the sea for a well-earned meal, measuring a
about 3 feet tall, the kings are the second largest of all penguins, eclipsed only by the emperors. This is from the Scientific American. I'm going to read you a Smithsonian magazine on seabirds. Manx shearwaters breed on islands in the North Atlantic, where they make nests in underground burrows. The seabird species dives deeper when the water is clear. Scientists suggest that cloudier waters, caused in part by climate change, could make it harder for manx shearwaters to catch fish. On a small island off the coast of team of scientists spent last summer scooping up pretty black and white seabirds from their underground burrows so they could attach minuscule trackers to their backs. Using saltwater-resistant tape, the researchers affixed a tiny tracking device to the feathers of manx shearwaters, which are known for their graceful flights just above the surface of the ocean. By the end of the summer, scientists' insight into these impressive flights, as well as the bird's dives deep under the water. The goal of the study, which was published today in Proceedings of the Royal Society B, was to understand how underwater visibility affects seabirds' ability to forage for fish and other prey. Human activities causing climate change, coastal oceans, and marine pollution are making it harder to see underwater. In particular, altered wave patterns due to climate change have steered up ocean floor sediments, reducing the clarity of the water. But all of these factors that make the water clearer could be making it increasingly difficult for marine animals like seabirds to find and catch their food. Yet this issue has received a relative attention from conservation biologists. I really wanted to try and do this topic some justice because it's something that's kind of flown under the radar, says Jamie Darby, a marine ecologist at University College Cork and lead author of the study. Colleagues analyzed the diving patterns of manx shearwaters along with local environmental conditions like cloud cover and water clarity. They found that the birds dove deeper when sunlight could penetrate farther underwater, suggesting the visibility is key to their ability to dive for food. He says this finding is important because it means that seabirds, many of which already face the threats like entanglement and fishing gear, could have an additional hurdle to overcome as the planet warms and parts of the ocean become cloudier. Whether manx shearwaters are less capable of diving for fish when their underwater visibility is compromised, Darby and colleagues first needed to know where, when, and how deep the birds were diving, which is where the trackers came in handy. The specialized devices EMS a range of relevant information about weather patterns and ocean conditions. This included the cloud cover, the angle of the sun above the horizon, the clarity of the sea, at all geographic locations and time points covered by the trackers. After re-catching the sheer waters as they returned to their island burrows, the researchers carefully removed the trackers. They then downloaded the bird movement data and combined it with the environmental data to see how diving behavior related to visibility. Although they only tracked 36 individual shearwaters, they managed to record over 5,000 different dives, providing a huge data set to work with. The sun was higher in the sky. These results supported the idea that the birds needed sufficient sunlight permeating deep under the sea surface of the water to be able to forage at depth. But without measuring the actual amount of food caught by the birds, researchers couldn't be sure if and to what extent seabirds' diet is negatively impacted by poor underwater visibility. Benjamin Van Dorn, an ecologist at the Cornell Lab of Ornithology, who was not involved in the study, suggests that future research look into exactly how visibility affects the birds' feeding success, energy use, and ultimately survival. But he adds that this study clearly shows that light plays an integral role in the shearwaters' diving behavior. Well, this research focused on mixed shearwaters, the relationship it revealed between foraging and visibility. To other marine animals as well. I think anything that is visually dependent and dives will probably experience some effect of water turbidity, says Darby. Many animals could find themselves struggling to find food as human activities continue to make Sparkier, he says. Reduced underwater visibility may also make it harder for marine animals to spot and avoid potential threats, such as boats and fishing nets. A previous study showed that seals get tangled in fishing nets more often when water is less clear. And based on the result of the shearwater study, Darby thinks the same could be true for seabirds as well. When adding lights or high contrast colors to the was not involved in the study, seabirds face a wide range of threats due to human activities on both land and water. They live in both worlds, right? They have a portion of their life history that depends on land, and a portion of their life history that depends on the ocean, she says. Bryce explains that everything from overfishing to coastal development can add up to put these birds in danger. A 2012 study showed that more than a quarter of the world's 346 seabird species were threatened, and almost half were suspected of having declining populations. Now it seems be contributing to this decline. As Bryce says, it's another source of impact for seabirds, which are already being hammered by so many other things. Alright guys, let's